Malcolm Arnold's Three Sea Shanties was composed in 1943, and it's one of the better-known wind quintets because of the quirky and imaginative way the composer reinterprets three well-known tunes. In this short video, we're going to explore what harmony and chords are and how they can be used to change the overall sound and feel of just one melody. This will help us understand how harmony can affect the overall mood of a piece of music. So, first of all, what is harmony? Well, music would be a bit boring if it was just a series of notes played one at a time, all the time. So, in order to portray certain feelings and emotions, composers combine notes to be played together at the same time. And when more than one note is played at the same time, that's what creates harmony. So you have one note, another note, play them at the same time to create a chord. So as you can see from the music on the graphic, the two notes that create that harmony are stacked on top of one another because they're played at the same time. Harmonies with three or more notes are called chords, and one of the most common chords is called a triad. Tri means three, so the chord is made up of three notes. To create a triad, let's have a look at this combination of notes from the C major scale using the white notes on a piano. C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C. So to build the triad, you choose one of the notes from that scale, for example, C. You miss a note out, miss out D, so then play E. Miss one out, play the next, G. Play them together, and that's your three notes to create the triad. The notes that are chosen for the chord change the quality of the sound. For example, if you choose notes from the same scale, that can sound quite pleasing, and what we call in music, a consonant sound. Consonance in music is really easy to listen to, but can be a little bit bland if there's too much of it. Other combinations of notes can create a more uneasy, or what we call in music, a dissonant sound. This gives the music a bit of tension and drama. Now let's take a look at one of the tunes in Malcolm Arnold's Sea Shanties. This is the first bit of the melody from a traditional song called Boney is a Warrior, which the second movement of Sea Shanties is based on. Now we can add notes to accompany that tune to create harmony. This piece uses notes from the D major scale. If I wanted to create a consonant, pleasing sound in harmony, I could create chords using notes from this scale to accompany the tune. Let's try composing some triads that will be played on every other bar. As you can hear, that creates a nice, easy listening accompaniment for that tune. But now, let's try creating some chords that are not from the D major scale. That music sounds really different to the first example and gives much more of an uneasy feeling.
So, the choices you make for the notes in a chord
will depend on the overall mood you're trying to portray. Composers use harmony alongside other elements of music, such as melody, rhythm, dynamics, texture. And when those elements are combined together, that helps convey certain emotions, feelings, and moods. Take a listen to the first movement of Sea Shanties, which is based on the tune, What Shall We Do With a Drunken Sailor? Sometimes the composer uses dissonant harmonies, and perhaps this is to convey the sense of the sailor being drunk or unsteady on his feet. At other times, the composer uses more consonant harmonies alongside fast rhythms, perhaps to convey the sense that the sailor's having fun. Thinking about chords and harmony, can you create new accompaniments for other well-known tunes as a starting point for one of your compositions?